All right, Vinco Vintage Racer, we have now a Hodaka. This is a very popular bike. I think they made like 1.2 million of these or something. Wasn't it a ton?
Yeah, they made a zillion of them. Honda wishes they sold that many bikes today.
Right. So this is Don Hutchinson. He's got this great collection of bikes. And this is a bike my uncle had, and he raced these in the early 70s. And so they're kind of cool. Combat Wombat, right? They came up with cool names like that.
Yeah, Dirt Squirt, Road Toad. Yeah, they just had this real groovy kind of vibe going.
Yeah, and so, you know, Yamaha got on that later with their quad names, you know, with Raptor and Grizzly. Yeah. And I think those kind of names were cool. And so I think that was kind of cool. We were talking about this bike in the early 70s. Wasn't there just a ton of these around being raced?
Yeah, I mean, Hodakas in the early 70s really got a lot of people into riding motorcycles. I mean, the Super Rats, the 90s, the 100s, those bikes, they sold a ton of them. They were fairly cheap, and I think a lot of guys got started on Hodakas.
Because they were somewhat inexpensive, guys could get, right. People were riding like crazy, because I think they were only $300 or $400, right?
Yeah, cheap. Yep. And fairly easy to work on, really plentiful. Like I said, they made a ton of them. The aftermarket guys, you know, in the early 70s, like Webco, they were making all the aftermarket parts for them, Webco heads and all the stuff to hop them up. And so they were really famous for these metal chrome tanks. A lot of guys call them chrome toasters.
Toaster tanks. So one thing, just a little, so we have a little bit of history for those that don't know, because I'm sitting here going, man, these are made in Japan. Why didn't Hodaka keep going as Honda came in with those Elsinores? What happened?
They just didn't put enough energy and time into really, and maybe they didn't even have the budget for it at the time, because as soon as the 73 Elsinore, 74 Elsinores were out, these bikes were obsolete. Those bikes were better, faster in every way. And this was a 125. Hodaka did come out with a 250, but it was too little, too late.
Yeah.
They just could, you know, they just could, especially once the sales started to suffer, that the Japanese just got ahead of them. You know, and at that time, especially the Suzukis, when Suzuki came out with the RM, you know, that was a 76, and the Hondas, and then Kawasaki was starting to build bikes. Yamaha had really good bikes all through the 70s. These guys just didn't have the budget and the resources to be able to keep up with innovation, because at that time that they were selling so many bikes and there was so much budget for R&D, the bikes were leapfrogging every year.
Yeah. When I listen to a lot of the history, I've been listening to a lot of shows, you know, different shows like Whiskey Throttle Show, different things, and you hear some of this history and how much development was just happening from year to year. It's crazy. But we were talking before we got on about how when you take this bike to a show or something, or multiple bikes, this is the one that always everyone wants photos of.
Yeah, that's been my experience. If I take this and line it up next to a Mako and next to an RM465, more people will take pictures of this bike. The tank, the chrome fenders, stainless fenders, it is a really pretty motorcycle.
I like just how simplistic it looks. Everything is just so there. I just like, they have a really good look and feel to them. And of course with the little battle motif looking, and you said they were based up in Oregon when they were bringing these in.
Yeah, the importer was based out of Oregon,
so that's really interesting. So I'm sure there's a lot of people that have history with these Hodakas, and just a fun looking bike.
And you can still buy most any part for them. I mean, they're not a cheap bike to restore. They can tend to be a little expensive. I mean, the tanks alone are expensive to restore, but in general, the bikes are. As far as getting parts and pieces for them, they're pretty easy to restore. There's a lot that, and like I said, because they made so many of them.
Yeah, that's great. Well, that's awesome. All right, hope you enjoy this Hodaka. Check you out next time.